Hello again. Today we are going to be talking about the word divination. Divination. You might not have heard too much about this word, but it's a word that's found in throughout the Bible. It's found in the Old Testament. It's found in the New Testament. And so what does the word divination mean? In the Bible, this refers to witchcraft or evil spirits. In Bible times, as well as today, there were people who would try to talk to the spirits. They would try to communicate with them. Today, there are people who claim that they can talk to the dead. Understand that this is evil and this is divination. Many people are interested in palm readers or psychics or those that read tarot cards. Understand that this is divination. It's demonic. Many people, they like to watch horror movies that have ghosts in them or demons. Understand that this is divination. This is used of the devil. Any time that you are involved in things that provoke evil spirits, you're playing with fire. And understand that a child of God should not be meddling with these things. God does not desire for us to view these things, to entertain these things. And so we need to understand that there are evil spirits and we should not want anything to do with them. There are people in the world that are influenced by the devil. And we as God's children, we must be on guard. We must watch out because understand that the devil is a liar. And understand that his demonic forces are at work in other people's lives, and so as well as our own. He's constantly trying to attack our minds, and there is a continual spiritual war, a spiritual battle that is happening in your mind every single day. And so understand that we have to be on guard. We have to be alert. So what should we do with all that? Well, stay away from these evil things. Stay away from things that are centered around evil spirits, that are centered around divination. Stay focused on the Lord and the things that are spiritually healthy for the mind. Stay in the Word of God. Stay in prayer. Focus your mind on things that revolve around our Creator, revolve around Almighty God. And so lastly, I want to say this. We must remember that God is bigger and stronger than the devil and evil spirits, and we should always stay close to Him. Draw nigh to God, and He will draw nigh to you. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. But we first of all must draw, submit ourselves unto God, and draw close to Him. I'm reminded of the verse that says, greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. Focus your mind and your heart on that today. Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified, laid behind the stone, you lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose Trampled on the ground, you took the fall and thought of me above all. Like a rose trampled on the ground, you took the fall and thought of me above all. Our wonderful God, we thank you and praise you because you are above all. God, I pray that we would dwell upon you, that we would center our minds and our hearts around you, your word, and being in communication with you through prayer, and Father, singing songs and praises to you. God, that we would not meddle around in the things of the devil. And Father, that we would steer clear of that and stay away from that. And Father, help us to realize and to understand that we cannot draw near to you while at the same time flirting with the enemy. And God, help us to make the choice and the right decision to draw close to your side. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.